is what? Difference between tax base of assets and liabilities with the carrying amount of asset and liability, which is called temporary difference. Temporary differences are classified into two parts. One, it can be taxable temporary differences, or two, it can be deductible temporary differences. Taxable temporary differences is a difference which will result into future for payment of tax. Deductible temporary difference is this difference will result in the future as a tax deduction. Hence, it will result into deferred tax asset. Higher. The tax base of asset is higher than the carrying amount of asset. In the future, I will get higher tax deduction by way of maybe deposition charge or some else as per the Income Tax Act. So then it is my deferred tax asset, deductible temporary differences. Reverse the situations for liabilities. Objective. The objective of IAS 12 is to prescribe the accounting treatment for income taxes. It says that how to account for current and future tax consequences for the future recovery and for transactions and other events of the current period. So if you look at IAS 12 objective, IAS 12 says that there are two aspects which are covered. First, deferred tax. Second, current tax. So in objective part A, it talks about a deferred tax, says that future recovery. Future recovery or settlement of the carrying amount of assets or liabilities, and that are recognized in an entity's statement of financial position. And transactions and other events of the current period that are recognized in an entity's financial statements. So the objective of IAS 12 is to provide the accounting for current tax and deferred tax both. Generally, when you look at about income tax standard, we always say the income tax is about deferred tax. But yes, if you look at the accounting standards paragraph, 90% of the standards are basically on deferred tax, and only a certain portion is on current tax. So you always feel that the standard is for deferred tax. It is not only for deferred tax, it covers both current tax and deferred tax. Recognize detail for all taxable temporary differences that meet the basic concept. Generally, when you look at the recognition of liability, is straightforward. If you have to recognize liability, it is not so much difficult. Recognition of liability is straightforward. But if you recognize asset, in that case, one has to be more cautious. Why? Because asset itself says it has to be resource controlled by an entity and from which future economic benefits is expected to flow to the entity. So recognize the DTA for all deductible temporary differences. You have to judge at probability of availability of sufficient taxable profit and review or reassess recognize and unrecognize DTA at each reporting date. So recognition of DTA is not only a 1 year period, it is not only one reporting period exercise. Every reporting period you have to reassess the recognition of DTA. Is it required, not required? In that case, recognition of DTA is straightforward. Why? Because in the future, when my deductible temporary difference reverses, and same way there will be reversal of taxable temporary differences, hence reversal of deductible temporary differences is going to be offset against taxable temporary difference reversal. Hence, there will be at least a balance of DTL. If available, I am sure of recovery of DTL. So, if I am having a sufficient taxable temporary difference available, I don't have any issue. I will create DTA. If sufficient taxable temporary difference is not available, then we need to consider two important things. One, whether sufficient future taxable profit is available. And two, whether the tax planning opportunity is available. So, because then we